2 minutes. We would like to clear the dealer's room, please. You have 2 minutes to get into the auditorium.
I will. Probably will.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our Carl Bajor Magic Fun Day. Please settle down, because we've got a 3-hour show tonight and only 2 hours to do it in. So hold on to your seats, because without any further ado, I'd like to introduce you tonight that very beautiful lady magician, none other than Miss Shelly Carol.
should give yourselves a nice round of applause. You're wonderful. Let's hear it for you in the house. Does anybody have a dollar bill that I could borrow?
Yes, I do.
Yes, you do. There's one in every crowd. Hi there. What's your first name?
Bill.
Hi, Bill. That's correct. Bill, put your drink over on the table. Now, Bill, just stand right there. Bill, have you ever done magic before?
No.
Good. Just stand over the trap door. Bill, I'm going to show you how to increase your money. Take the bill and fold it in half. Fold it in half again. Fold it in half again. This is a sobriety test. Fold it in half again. Yeah, any way at all. That's it. End to end. Now, Bill, here I come. This is how I pay the rent, Bill. I would like a nice round of applause for the gentleman who lent me his dollar bill.
Oh, my goodness.
Bill, do you think your dollar increased?
No.
No? Don't trust me. Come on up here. Take the dollar, step right up here. Makes the act look bigger. Open the dollar up. With a little bit of luck, the bill will be increased. Is the bill increased?
Yes, it's increased.
Still a dollar? But see the creases? I told you I was going to increase your money. Well, Bill, I can't make your money appear, but I can only make it disappear. But it's a great way to get you up here to help me with this next effect, don't you think? Let's give him a nice round of applause. Don't go away. Evidence of a misspent youth. I'll tell you what, Bill. Open your dollar up. Yep, open it right up. And you'll notice on the top and the bottom, there are serial numbers. Letters, numbers, other letters. That's how you differentiate one bill from the next. Would you do me a favor, Bill? And would you read the number off from the dollar, letters, numbers, everything? Yep.
B, 3, 4, 2, 3, 5, 9, 2, M.
Bingo! Another cruise ship victim, I know. I'll tell you what, Bill. Before we do that, I've got a little chalkboard and a magic marker. You take the magic marker. But before I do this, I would just like to show everyone in the audience that there is nothing here, and nothing here, nothing here, and nothing here, and nothing here, or here. Bill, open up the magic marker. Sign the number, put the number right there, as large as you possibly can. Yep. This is why there's nothing here.
Only the number?
Uh-huh. The letters, the number, everything. I have an appointment in July. Keep writing. And once Bill has finished writing the number down, I'm going to ask him to call the number off one more time from the bill, just to make sure he wrote it down right. That's good. Okay, Bill, would you read it from the dollar one more time? Right into the mic.
B, 3, 4, 2, 3, 5, 9, 2, M.
Terrific. Let's give him a nice round of applause. Okay, Bill. You hold on to the dollar, I'll take the pen back. Because now, Bill, it's time to play a little game called Let's Burn a Deal. I have five envelopes, Bill. Four of them are stuck down. One is stuck up. Would you examine each of those envelopes, hold them up to the light? You'll make sure that there is something in each of the envelopes. This one has nothing in it at all. That's good. We're not saying what it is. Whoops, first drop you had all day. Now, Bill, I'm going to take these back from you. You hold on to the dollar. Take the one that's open. Open it up. Crawl around inside of it. Make sure there's no crimps, no flaws, no breaks. Looks pretty good.
Nothing in it.
If you can see from there, take the bill, fold it in half, place it in the envelope, seal the envelope for me, Bill. Seal the envelope. You do that well. Place that practice. Who plays that right on top? Now, Bill, if I were to ask you which envelope contained your bill, you'd say the top one, right?
Sure.
That's good! But, Bill, if I now did something like this without looking, would you now know which envelope contained the bill?
Your guess is as good as mine.
Good! Because I've got enough of those envelopes, 1 through 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and last but not least, the number 5. Now, Bill, I've numbered those envelopes, 1 through 5, and I'm really the only one that knows which one actually contains your bill. I'm going to leave these right there, because for this part of the experiment, I need my glasses. Bill, have you ever met me before tonight? No, you seem proud of that fact, Bill. Bill, have you ever heard of ESP?
No.
Extra sensory perception. It's the ability to communicate, not through the mouth, but through the mind. Bill, I'm going to take your hand. Bill, I'm going to send you the impression of one number alone. When you receive that impression, Bill, I'd like you to call it out nice and loud. I don't know if this will work. Bill, concentrate. Bill, the first odd number between 1 and 5.
3.
3! Hold on to that 1 second.
We got number 3.
Are we over a sprinkler?
Don't see my dog's not there.
Oh, no. Trust me. I'm so sure, Bill, that your dollar is in the envelope. Yeah, ever had one of those days? Envelope mark number 3, that I have taken the liberty of burning the other 4 envelopes. Bill, for the last time, take your envelope, rip it open any way you want. Except that way, no. Take the dollar out of the envelope. And would you read the serial number off nice and loud?
Says you picked the wrong one.
It's hard to find good help. I hate this stupid trick. Anybody have any marshmallows? Bill, I'm going to give you these ashes to take home with you. I'd like you to take them to your bank manager tomorrow. He'll tell you what to do with it. This is a lemon of a trick, and it just laid an egg, didn't it? Speaking of lemons, that's the second time today. Good. One more to go. Did you see a lemon sitting around here anywhere? Not on 2 legs.
No, not on 2 legs.
Right there, there's a bowl on stage. It's been here during this entire performance. 3 lemons. I'll take this nonsense back from you. Bill, would you get the bowl, bring it over here to this table? That's great. Now you have 3 lemons in the bowl, right, Bill?
Right, 3.
Take any one you want out of that bowl. Except that one. No. Sure, you want that one? I'm going to take the rest.
You'll see.
Put them over here. In plain view. That's good. Stay. Bill, a plate. Would you examine the plate? It's a real plate. Place the plate on the table. Put the lemon on the plate. A knife. Now you'll notice it's French cutlery. J.C. Penney. Bill, would you take the knife and cut the lemon halfway through? But before you do, I'll give you one last chance. Do you want to change the lemon for another one in the bowl, or do you want to stick with that lemon? It's up to you. The door!
Take
that one. Good. We can't blame it on the Rolling Stones. Okay. Take that carton. You want that lemon? Bill, you're going to stick with that lemon, then take the knife and cut the lemon halfway through. Turn it over so it doesn't roll. Cut it halfway through. That's fine. Stop cutting. Take the knife out of the lemon and place it preferably on the table. That's good. Pick up the lemon. Come center stage with me and break that lemon open. It's great for mixers after the show. Break it open.
Oh. Holy God, my God!
Why am I glad he said that? And he got something to mix your cocktails with, Lex. Open the doll here. I'll take the lemon back. You're welcome to have the lemon if you want. At least it'll smell good.
That's my dollar.
Is it a dollar? I'll give you a handy one after the show. Bill, is it a dollar bill?
Yes, ma'am.
It's a dollar bill. For the last time, would you read the serial number off from the...